Shalom, shalom. This is your brother Shamak out of the Great Millstone Atlanta Camp. Before I get started, I want to give all the glory, infinite praises unto Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Rachai Kodash, Yahweh being the Heavenly Father's true name, and His only begotten Son's true name being Yahweh Shai, both in the Hebrew language, whom the world incorrectly calls God and Jesus Christ. Also, want to give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who teach and rule well, and who are the true leaders of the Hebrew Israelites in these last days. Also, I'm going to give a shalom to our sincere brothers that's pushing, teaching this truth worldwide, and shalom to all you sincere believers. All right, here with a lesson concerning the first fruits of the kingdom of heaven. All right, and I just, through the inspiration, truly just wanted to elaborate on this specific topic and this specific term that that those that may sincerely seek the truth of the scriptures of the Holy Bible, being you Negroes, Latinos, you Native Americans who are truly Hebrew Israelites according to the Bible, you know, this term or this topic is not complicated or rocket science, but it may go over, you know, one individual's head. You know, it may just, you know, it may just go over. All right. So I'm, you know, Lord willing, through the spirit of Yahweh Bashmi Al-Shai, here to edify on this specific topic concerning the first fruits. All right. But first, I wanted to grab the physical aspect, because I'm truly going into the spiritual aspect of the first fruits, but there's also a physical aspect concerning the sacrifices, all right, that was a part of our heritage before Yahweh Shai came on the scene. All right, this is Leviticus chapter 23 verse 10. It reads, speak unto the children of Israel, because that's who the law, statutes, commandments, and that's who this Bible is for. That's who know this message is for, you know, our own people only. Okay. And it reads, and say unto them, when ye be come into the land which I give unto you, and shall reap the harvest thereof, then ye shall bring a shift of the first fruits of your harvest unto the priest. So yeah, this is a physical, the first fruits within our heritage was a spiritual sacrifice, man. All right, the first fruits of your harvest. All right, concerning the new year. All right, I'm going down to verse 17. All right, you know, the first fruits of truly of everything, okay? I'm going down. It says, ye shall bring out of your habitations 2 wave loaves of 2-tenth deals. They shall be of fine flour, and they shall be baking with leaven. They are the first fruits of the Lord, okay? And I wanted to grab that first fruits term in the Hebrew from the blueletter.org. All right, the first fruits term there in Leviticus chapter 23. All right, in the Hebrew word, which is pronounced Ra'ash Yaft. Okay, Ra'ash meaning head, or in a Yaf, adding on to the plural of the term. So the term going into heading, all right? The true definition going to heading, all right? Which is alongside with, as it's broken down, it says first beginning. So yeah, heading, you know, slash beginning. Those, you know, likewise, you know, and corresponds with each other, all right? It says first beginning, best, chief, okay, in choice part. All right, so this is the first fruits physically in our heritage, man. We offer this sacrifice unto the Lord. That was part of our sacrifice, and that is a sacrifice. You know, that's, you know, that was your you know, your labors. You know, you sacrificed it as part of the heritage, you know, to continue that mercy from Yahweh. All right, so yeah, the first, the beginning, the best, the chief. You know, so basically the cream of the crop. All right. So I wanted to grab that physical aspect before grabbing the spiritual, because this helps bring forth the understanding, you know, concerning the spiritual aspects of the first fruits of the kingdom of heaven. All right, what has to do heavily in today's time and concerning the last days, all right, that we're living in now before our Savior Yahweh Shai returns. Okay, so I want to grab Revelation chapter 14. Okay, so this is Revelation chapter 14. And I'm gonna start at the top, okay? So this is Revelation chapter 14. Let me highlight it. Verse 1. All right, and it reads, now, mind, of course, concerning the book of Revelation, this is John on Island of Patmos receiving these visions. All right, so he's explaining what he sees. All right. So it reads, and I looked, and lo, a lamb. It's that capital L, which is a spiritual sign, a spiritual indicator. This is going to Yahweh Shai, that sacrificial lamb. Yahweh Shai sacrificed himself for the nation of Israel. That's why we're able to receive the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of these scripts in today's time. All right, due to Yahweh Shai's sacrifice, man. Okay, and he's going to get his reward, you know, in due time when he returns, man, with judgment and power, with power and great glory. Okay, it says a lamb stood on the Mount Zion. Mount Zion, Zion in Hebrew is pronounced to Zion, meaning a memorial. All right, going into the nation of Israel, we are that Mount Zion, we are that memorial. We are the Israelites, Yasha'Allah. We are the memorial of Yahweh Bashmi Awashai. All right, the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son. All right, it says, and with Him, 144,000 having His Father's name written in their foreheads. Okay, that's a spiritual and governing body. Okay, it reads verse 2. And I heard, it's going to go more into it. You know, it says, the scriptures explain it best. Verse 2, and I heard a voice from heaven, as the voice of many waters, and as the voice of a great thunder. That's the power and the glory of Yahweh Shai. Now, you know, the Lord's only begotten Son, His first creation. All right, it says, and I heard the voice of harpers harping with their harps. Verse 3, and they sung as it were a new song before the throne, and before the four beasts and the elders, and no man could learn that song but the 144,000 which were redeemed from the earth. And that new song is a symbolic term, man. That's going into the wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and the, you know, of the truth. Okay, the doctrine, the body of teachings, man. All right, that the predestined individuals were meant to receive the truth from the beginning of time. Okay, verse 3, one more time. And they sung as it were a new song before the throne and before the four beasts and the elders, and no man could learn that song but the 144,000 which were redeemed from the earth. All right, that's spiritually. Okay, verse 4, these are they which were not defiled with women. All right, and confusion comes with this verse in itself. You know, this is, that could be another topic in itself. This is the women is concerning the philosophies, the ways, you know, the false ways, you know, and the fornication, you know, that are in contrast with Yahweh Shai, you know. But through the Spirit, through the Holy Spirit, through the Ruach HaKodesh, you know, of that new song and of that cleansing by the word, you know, these spirits are not defiled with women. For they are, it says, for they are virgins. All right, we're being made clean. All right, by the washing of the word. Verse, continuing on. These are they which follow the Lamb, follow Yahweh Shai, disciples. All right, whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men, being the first fruits unto the Most High and to the Lamb. All right, I want to get that word or that term there in the Greek, first fruits. All right, as we did in the Hebrew, grab Ra'ashiyah. All right, meaning the beginning, heading. It says what the best and the chief. All right, that's still in effect concerning the New Testament. All right, but the Greek term there in Revelation chapter 14 verse 4 for first fruits. I'll play it out loud.
Strong's G 536. Aparche. Aparche.
All right, so there you have it. Aparche. Okay, aparche. Okay, meaning it says to offer firstlings or first fruits, as we grabbed in Leviticus chapter 23 as part of the Israelites' heritage. That was a part of our culture. All right, but the spiritual aspect is going to explain as well. Definition number 2. To take away the first fruits of the productions of the earth, which was offered to the Most High, the first portion of the dough for which sacred loaves were to be prepared. Okay, hence term used of persons consecrated to the Most High for all time. All right, so now it went into the spiritual aspect going into those spiritual beings, man, 144,000, the elect. All right, the remnant. All right, it says, look, it says person superior in excellence to others of the same class, you know. So this is the excellence of the nation of Israel. All right, the nation of Israel is already a chosen. We are already a chosen nation. We are already a special people, a peculiar people. All right, but there's an excellency, you know, a special class, you know, superior beings of the nation of Israel. All right, and that's concerned, and that's the first fruits, man. Okay, and I wanted to grab the I had a definition. Let's see if I can grab it. All right, yeah, the definition, and this is a screenshot or a picture, I should say, of the image taken, you know, from I have my own personal study Bible. Okay, and just to grab there, you know, elaboration of the first fruits. It reads, it says, they follow the Lamb and reign with him. As the first fruits of the redeemed, they are the first to be saved during the tribulation period. It says, following the rapture of the church, a characteristic of the redeemed is that they are without guile or falsehood. So yeah, through waking up to the truth and through relearning and reorchestrating our mind through the Holy Spirit with the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of these scriptures, you know, we are cleansed, man. We have taken away that guile and falsehood out of our lives, you know. And it's concerning those that are predestined to be saved in these last days now through this tribulation period that is up, that is going to continue to get worse before Yahweh Shah returns to deliver the first fruits, man, in a great multitude. All right. But I'll continue. It says, that's the point. It says, as the first fruits of the redeemed, they are the first to be saved during the tribulation period. And that's exactly what we're striving striving for, man, as he hopefully let, to be the first fruits, to be delivered in these last days, man, to escape judgment. That's the whole point, man. All right. Because we'll list out being delivered, and that salvation is only for Israel, and that, you know, concerning Israelites. You know, of the nation, you know, of the Israelites, okay, that are meant to be destroyed concerning two-thirds, concerning the wicked of our own people. And on this side, during this tribulation period before Yahweh Shah returns, or when Yahweh Shah returns, we also bring out the point and continue to reiterate that through reincarnation and through being reborn, all right, those spirits that are judged when Yahweh Shah does come back in the two-thirds, you will be reborn. You're through reincarnation in the kingdom of heaven. So ultimately, yeah, concerning the scripture, Romans chapter 11, verse 26, all Israel will be saved, you know? All Israel will be saved. But we're striving to be those first fruits to escape the judgment, to be the first, you know, part of that governing body to help establish the kingdom of heaven that will be on earth. That's what we're striving to be, as the hopeful elect. Part of the first fruits, man, the first to be delivered, you know? So it's heavy. Okay, it's we are in a heavy, you know, we have a heavy opportunity and a heavy chance, you know, and a great chance at that. Okay, long as we wait and endure to the end to be delivered, to be saved, as the scriptures speak about in Matthew chapter 24, verse 13. But I continue on with Revelation chapter 14. You know, I'll read verse 4 one more time. These are they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. So yeah, we are cleansed through the washing of the word. That falsehood, those philosophies, all right, we're not defiled with that anymore, okay? With the wickedness, all right? These are they which follow the Lamb. We follow Yahweh Shai, man, the only begotten Son. It says, whithersoever he goeth, these were redeemed from among men, being the first fruits unto the Most High and to the Lamb. And in their mouth was found no guile, for they are without fault before the throne of the Most High. So yeah, this the first fruits, you know, are that cream of the crop, that best choice for Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai. And this is all through predestination. Let me see if I had another term. Let me grab first, because we mentioned the term Rashiyaf. Okay, this is from also from the study Bible, you know, another screenshot or image. It says Prototokos. All right, Prototokos, you know, Salaki if I mispronounce. But it says first in time. It says first in place. Preeminence. All right. It says the Son of Man is the chief born among all God's creation. That's what makes Yahweh Shai Yahweh's only begotten Son, man. All right. This first choice, first of all his creation. All right. He had Yahweh Shai in the elect establish the earth. Okay. Or create his creation, I should say. It says among all God's creation and the preeminent. It says, but the destination is in no way indicates that Yahweh Shai was created by the Most High, for all things are created in, through, and for Yahweh Shai. He is the Son of God. It says, oh, that's true. It's truly the point. But being the point being first in time, first in place. Okay. And that's because it also coincides with the first fruits, man. First in time, first in place, man. We're looking to be the first ones delivered on those chariots. Okay. So from there, I want to grab 1 Corinthians, all right? 1 Corinthians, that also touches on the first fruits. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 15. Oh, yeah, see, it's already highlighted. 1 Corinthians chapter 15. I'm going to go to, start at verse 19. If in this life only we have hope in Yahweh Shai, we are of all men most miserable. But now is Yahweh Shai risen from the dead and become the first fruits of them that slept. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. So yeah, through Yahweh Shai, you know, he conquered sin. You know, he conquered death, okay? So that others may fall in that same lot, you know? For we sinned, you know, as Adam sinned, okay? And Yahweh Shai being that what? That first Adam, okay? Sinned, but also he also made what? He resurrected from the dead, you know? Not reincarnated, but resurrected right then and there. The same is going to happen likewise for those that believe in Yahweh Shai in these times, okay? Verse 22. For as Adam, I may jump the gun. It says, verse 22 says, for as in Adam all die, even so in Yahweh Shai shall all be made alive, man. Okay? So it says, but every man his own order, Yahweh Shai the first fruits, afterward they are Yahweh Shai's at his coming. Okay? So the first fruits are truly the Israelites, you know, basically the sacrifice for Yahweh Shai's. We are bought with a price, as the scriptures speak about. You know, this is bought with a price. All right, we know this. Scriptures speak about, you know, being in the faith on the bondage under Yahweh Shai. Okay, basically going into the same as with being bought with a price. It's a sacrifice, man. Okay, it says let's see, verse 24. It says, then cometh the end when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to the Most High, delivered the Israelites, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and all authority and power, for he must reign till he have put all enemies under his feet. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. And concerning the kingdom of heaven, that will be established on earth alone. We will be, you know, Lord willing, we'll be a part of that number, you know, personally, you know. But there will be no more death, man. No more sorrow, no more crying, all right? No more weeping. Okay, concerning Revelation chapter 21, verse 4, concerning the kingdom of heaven. And that's prophecy. That will happen. That's why it's so important to be a part of that first fruits, man, to escape the judgment, to, you know, to reign with Yahweh Shai, be those first choice spirits, man. And this is all through predestination. That's another aspect of the first fruits, man. Predestination. So I want to grab Ephesians chapter 1. All right, Ephesians chapter 1, verse 4. And it reads, according as he have chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. That goes back, and that's backing up Revelation chapter 14, verse 4, concerning not defiled with women. All right, being without what? Being without blame before him in love. But it says, has chosen us in him before the foundation of the world. So before the world was even created, the Lord has a particular 144,000, then the elect predestined spirits to believe in the truth and to also be delivered in these last days we're living in now, thousands of years ago, all right, before the foundation of the world. So this goes beyond, this is beyond ourselves. This is nothing, it's totally spiritual. It's nothing we could do about it, man. It's just the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai through predestination. All right, we don't control whether we wake up and who we wake up. It's all through the Holy Spirit, man. This is all the doings of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right. It says, verse 5, having predestined us unto the adoption of children by Yahweh Shai HaMashiach to himself according to the good pleasure of his will. So, yeah, we, Lord willing, we'd be a part of that number. We were predestined to believe in his truth, you know. We were predestined and adopted. We were brought back to our power, man. All right. We were brought back through Yahweh Shai. It says by Yahweh Shai HaMashiach to himself according to the good pleasure of his will. All right. And another chapter that touches on this aspect is Romans chapter 8. All right. And I want to grab, on Romans chapter 8. But I want to start up in the chapter a little bit and read on down. I want to see how far I want to go down, but that should, it should be highlighted already. All right. But this is Romans chapter 8. I'm going to start up a little bit. This is Romans chapter 8, verse 20. All right, and it reads, for the creation was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who have subjected the same in hope. You know, so Lord, so yeah, that's the scriptures speak about our faith, our slacking, Our righteousness is as filthy rags, but it's made clean through our faith in Yahweh Shai. All right, that's where that without spot or without blemish comes into play spiritually. Okay, verse 21, because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of the Most High. Who are the children of the Most High? The Israelites. Okay, you Negroes, Latinos, you Native Americans. All right, it's time for us to wake up, man. All right, it's time to wake up out of sleep. All right. And realize that Yahweh Shai is coming back. America's going to be destroyed. All right. You have a chance at deliverance. All right. Verse 22. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit. Even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our body. All right. Because concerning deliverance as well. We're going to be changed, man. We're going to be given new bodies, okay? Verse 24, it says, for we are saved by hope. Yeah, we are saved by our faith. That's the spiritual aspect of the first fruits. We are saved by our faith, okay? And but with faith also has to come with what? Works, okay? Has to come with labor. Has to come with proof that you believe in Yahweh B'Shemiah Shai. And that's through many aspects and forms. Tithing, reading, praying, fasting, charity. Okay, you know, teaching, you know, defense of the gospel. All right, all these aspects, man. Enduring, you know, it says, but hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man seeth, why do he yet hope for? Yeah, because the hope, you know, faith is the evidence of the things, you know, hope for, but not seen, man. It says verse 25, but says, but if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. And that's exactly what we're doing, man. We're waiting for Yahweh B'Shemiah Shai to give us that power and that great glory that was promised to us by via the scriptures, man, via the Holy Bible. All right, that's prophecy. That's prophetic. All right, this is to happen, okay? Verse 26, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh the intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is in the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints. And the saints, of course, are the children of Israel, the Israelites, according to the will of the Most High. Verse 28 is going actually more into the point concerning the first fruits. All right. It says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love the Most High, to them who are called according to his purpose. See, verse 29, for whom he did foreknow. See, it was through predestination. The Lord already knew our spirit. We're just in different bodies, but same spirit, man. That's why the truth is deep, man. You know, you can't understand the first fruits without being, you know, spiritual, or that, and also without believing in reincarnation. It says, verse 29, for whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his son, the likeness of Yahweh Shai, coming in that correct and that pure spirit. It says that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Verse 30, moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. So he already preordained, you know, for those that believe wholeheartedly in the truth and sincerely and on the right path. All right, or who are meant to be to you know, end on the right path, okay? They were already preordained to, you know, this is already meant to take place, man. All right, before you was in the womb, before you was even thought of, all right, before that action even took place, all right, you were meant to wake up to the knowledge of the wisdom, to the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of these scriptures, and to believe until the end in Yahweh B'Shemiah Shai. It says, them he also called, and we're in that process now. We're in the midst of being called now. It says, in whom he called, them he also justified. So we're looking to be justified by who? Our Savior, Yahweh Shai, man, by our faith and works. It says, in whom he justified, them he also glorified. And that glory is going to come concerning the kingdom of heaven, rulership, dominion over the other nations. And we're going to, in the upper class, being in the upper class and the supreme of the nation of Israel. All right. Those first fruits in that elect, that new governing body, is not going to be your regular Israelite, man, especially in the kingdom of heaven. All right, verse 31. What shall we say then, Shlaki? What shall we then say to these things? If the Most High be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, That was a sacrifice, man. That's why Yahweh Shai is known as that lamb. It says, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? And that's through the Rechak Wadash, man. He's given us the spirit to understand these mysteries and these prophecies concerning the Holy Bible that the world cannot understand, that new song, the doctrine, the teachings, all right, the understandings. All right, verse 33. That's why it's a gift. The faith is a gift. You know, it starts with faith and fear, man. It says, who shall lay anything to charge of the Most High's elect? That's going to the first fruits, man. All right. It is the Most High that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Yahweh Shai that died. Yeah, rather, that is risen again, because he went up on a chariot. He's going to return in that same glory as spoken about with Acts chapter 1, who is even at the right hand of the Most High, who also maketh intercession for us. So yeah, Yahweh Shai is our mediator between the Israelites and Yahweh. Okay, through Yahweh Shai we gain deliverance, man. Okay, and we able to connect back to our heavenly Father Yahweh. All right, and verse 35: Who shall separate us from the love of Yahweh Shai? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? So yeah, that's concerning the first fruits, man. The first fruits and the elect and the remnant are guaranteed to be saved. All right. The thing about it is we hope that we are part of that first fruit. We hope that's what we know as the hopeful elect, you know. So when you hear that, when one may hear of the term first fruits, hey, you think of the elect, you think of salvation, you think of deliverance, you think of being preordained and predestined to receive, you know, basic salvation, you know, and it be in new governing body with Yahweh Shai under King David to rule the planet Earth, man. To govern the nation of Israel and also these other nations forever and ever. That's going to be a position you have forever and ever. Think upon the elites. Think upon these celebrities. Think upon those that have a great status in today's society. But then times a million. That's going to be the elect. That's going to be the first fruits, man, position. And that's going to be something that's going to be forever, because there won't be any death. There won't be any no more war. No more coming against the authority, coming against power. No, the first one's going to have that position forever and ever, man. So, and that's going to be this is what we're fighting for. You know, this is what we believe in. And it's going to happen due to Bible prophecy. All right. So, Lord willing, you know, concerning this topic and concerning the first fruits and the term and the understanding of the first fruits was helpful, you know, and edifying as well. And also as well as encouraging. All right. I will end off by giving all the glory, infinite praises unto Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rechak Wadash. All right, double honor to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. And for the Israelites, for you, for our people, man, repent, Yahweh Shai is coming back. Repent, Yahweh Shai is coming back. All right, shalom. Keep the faith, shalom.